Well, they, should we wait or should we?
Does someone volunteer to inform the people downstairs or wherever they are?
Yeah, sure.
We should do that.
There's another proposal.
A lot bigger.
Thank you, Dinner Soul.
Should I hold my preamble for when they come back? Okay. The impetus for this statement was on day two of the occupation, another organization came to us with their own anti-war statement, much briefer, still fairly good, and said, come on, you guys, sign on to this. City Council did, why don't you? This was long before we even started thinking about how we're going to deal with other organizations and their statements and activities. And some of the concerns, specifically the intellectual founding of where they started their statement, was not the way we would have, many of us thought. And then at the same time, there was a strong feeling, especially among the veterans of Occupy Pittsburgh, that it would be worthwhile if the larger assembly group stood with what they were hoping to see and make some sort of statement. In the process of doing this, and if you look at how the first paragraph starts out, the reason I think it's a good idea to release such a statement as this is the larger world media, America, is somewhat unfairly, I would say, demanding that you need to tell us what you're about. You need to be specific. You need to say things. I think that's unfair because the movement itself is 2 months old, we're 2 weeks old, and we're dealing with incredibly complex problems. So the rest of the world just needs to be patient. On the other hand, I like how this starts because it addresses greed in many industries. It says there is greed here, there is greed there, there is greed elsewhere. But then it zeroes in on, but one thing we know, one thing you should all be able to agree on because it's so monstrous, greed as it affects foreign policy and war is awful. And to that extent, I think this is an intellectual defense of the movement. It throws up a way to show we are thinking, caring individuals. We have chosen a inarguable place to start our assault on greed. And it will serve as a rock to lean against as we continue to press forward. That is the end of the preamble. What you have the rest here is the statement as it has turned out so far, shuttling around between different interested parties over the past 10 days. If anyone has not seen it yet being passed around, I still have a few copies, but from there, I think we're ready to discuss it. Yes.
Raise your hand if you've got a copy. And you're willing to share. Okay. Find somebody.
I should hasten to add, it was written with the people's mic in it. And it was a fantasy of mine. We could actually go around the room with people reading it and everybody adding it.
That's just fiction.
That's just me.
Who's got spirit? Who's people's mic? Here are people. All right, that's what you're doing.
All right.
All right, if everybody's moved to join in, join
right, if you get tired.
Those corporations which are driven to profit
Nations have fought for freedom and for justice. They have also fought for resources and political advantage. We must know those differences. In the stated rationale of war shifts over years, that the alleged need to continue butchering human beings indoors, we must know those differences. We are told we fight for democracy. We find ourselves making deals with violent thugs, drug dealers, arms traffickers, and self-serving politics of an intelligent, of an illegitimate government imposed by aggressors as a mere act. War is harsh, and warfare is both large and personal. A young fighter would learn to think of the enemy as less than human, and to think of people as less than human. War is trauma. War is pain. War is pain. Brain injury, military sexual trauma from the epidemic of rape in the military, missing limbs, physical disabilities. We are not given the care and treatment we need. Oh no, the government will have to pay for that. We are instead labeled as having repressive anger, or we inform that we suffer from pre-existing conditions. Remain without care and treatment. So the nations and corporations continue extracting profit. When we invade a sovereign nation,
when we are made to invade a sovereign nation, the late great
nation. When we are made to invade a sovereign nation and go on raids, we detain people, civilians, humans. Political or corporate interests, we detain people, civilians, humans, children. We may interrogate them, torture them, abuse them. We are trained for this, but none of us can be prepared for this. If we are uninformed, or if we are uniformed military personnel, we may be held accountable. The army police protect, detain, and interrogate, but are often not. If we are corporate mercenaries, we will not. The privatization of warfare is upon us. Mercenaries are recruited as employees. Corporations offer military veterans with no other options. Vast sums of wealth to join the ranks of the unaccountable. When they finally arrive, they may be sent elsewhere to do a different job than that which they were led to accept. Under awful conditions, poorly sustained, unable to leave. Yet despite all of these crimes and injustices, many of us will go back again. Eagerly. Those that were left behind. We occupy this land to remind ourselves that it belongs to all of us and to no one. We are mindful that for the sake of this land, although many have sacrificed some have sacrificed all. And we should not be making sacrifices for your profit. And we should no longer be made to wage war over your bottom line.
At this point, you would normally ask the clarifying questions. Maybe there are there any clarifying questions, perhaps as to what this is going or anything?
I just have a question about, is this going to be one of many statements that the group would adopt, or is this two statements?
This proposal stands alone. I imagine that if this occupation lasts a long time, other statements may arise. It's difficult to generate consensus around a statement, so I don't think we're going to be doing one of these a week,
right,
or even a month, possibly.
It's just about the war.
Yes, this is just about
war. This is just a statement on the war. Any other clarifying questions? Anything you don't understand about the proposal? Okay. So we'll move into statements of concern and statements of support. We'll start taking stack for that. So just got one. Typer.
Yeah, I really like this site. I support this. The only little modification I may suggest might be the second page, but it says, yet when we return from these hells, I would rather not use that word hell, because that is actually for millions of people their homeland that has been illegitimately occupied. So what could turn hell into us is someone's homeland, as I said. So there is a way to reword this such that hell word is not there. It would be great. And then I would make the same suggestion. When we are made to invade a sovereign nation, or when we are made to police a foreign land, because that is the usual tactic for the ruling class to coerce, to co-opt the working class to do dirty things for them, making it sound like their interests and our interests are common, which is not the case. So that's why it's important to capture that it is we, but we are made to do these things, not necessarily for our own interests.
We are made to, I consider a friendly member, and we'll add those as many times as are appropriate in that paragraph.
Yeah, without actually, right.
The changing the wording from hell, I also take as a friendly member. However, we need to replace it with something. Or we could leave it alone. When we return from these hellish experiences,
We've turned these places into hell.
But there's still
places into the hell on earth. We did that. We're in the process. When they talk about the hell that we go through, you know, have you ever served?
Yeah.
Where you served at?
The church.
The church. So you fought, right?
No, I haven't taken.
Have you been in battle?
No, I haven't.
Okay, then. So therefore, hey, when you're in battle, it's hell, because there's a lot of killing going on. You know, one minute you got somebody standing there, next minute you see a pair of smoking damn boots.
I understand that.
So that is our hell. It is hell we go through as a fighting man.
Then maybe let's add from these hells we go through, so that the hell doesn't sound like the country that is the hell.
Yes.
Okay.
The hell you're going through. Right. Point of information, I did accept the word hell from another veteran from Occupy. So if we conclude it, if we can include these hells we go through,
yeah.
I feel like. Is anyone taking notes on?
Yeah.
Usually I'm looking for Sammy in these situations. She's taking his bag.
Other concerns? Good job, everybody.
Good job.
Sir?
Is there going to be
I'm sorry.
I didn't know what I was using, you know, and so it became apparent as I continued through.
You mean like a title or a
summary?
I'm not opposed. I'm opposed to a summary because it doesn't work.
Yeah.
I'm a little opposed to a sentence.
But then how do I know I'm going to be interested in reading this?
Sentence could say a lot of things.
Right.
Give me an example. I think I don't understand. I know that it is. I just don't think I understand what
it is. This is part of where that states, this is how we feel about
but in a nice sentence that will be possible to where we are. Because I don't just want to follow what they're doing, and I don't have to
I don't have a response to that yet.
Okay, so right now we're just going to take concerns to clarify, move the process. So concerns would be, do you have like a concern with this? And then we'll get to friendlies. I mean, not friendlies, we'll get to amendments. So yeah, Blue?
Yeah, my concern is this is not to be tight. This is for something for somebody to pick up and go and start reading it and go, oh, this is what this is all about. Yeah, they're right when they say this. It's not meant to be titled. Us veterans went through this twice before in the GA and never got anywhere with it. And finally, us veterans got together with other veterans organizations and went and spoke to city council today and presented our own letter. All right? These men and women out here are coming back from these wars are being fought. The wars are being fought by these big corporations. And what are we standing up for? If we're going to stand up for something, let's stand up for those men and women who are coming back and not getting health care. Those women who have been raped in the military and have nowhere to go to. Those women who have post-traumatic stress disorder and have no one to talk to. That's what this is all about. That's what this statement is about. It's not meant to be titled. It's meant for people to read it and suddenly get it in their head. Yeah, you're right.
Okay, next up we have Ran. All right, now we got Kristen.
Hey.
Yeah, go ahead, Kristen.
So I completely agree with an anti-war statement. I completely agree with this statement. I think that we should be careful not to alienate people by putting out an anti-war statement. And I feel like certain things in here, most especially the second paragraph on the second page, are going to alienate people who are anti-war and who agree with the statement as a whole. But to say things like, we're instead labeled as having repressive anger, like, who is that referring to? Who's labeling it? I feel like you're sort of labeling the entire military system, the entire healthcare system. I'm not quite sure.
That
but
was.
No, I just feel like, from someone who comes from a military family, I completely agree with your statement, but I find that a little bit personally offensive. Like you're kind of attacking me as opposed to the client.
I mean, just to share, I mean, my original draft was a lot less sharp in a lot of those ways, and it was after sharing it with some veterans. I mean, and that part, repressive anger, was something I got from multiple. There was an insistence that, like, we're not gonna make this clean and nice. We are gonna disturb. We are gonna disturb people.
I'm not arguing with the repressive anger part. I'm arguing with the, like, you say we are labeled by who, you don't specify. And I feel like if you're going to use strong language against somebody, you should specify who you're using that language against.
Okay, you can't have an extensive back and forth on every point.
And I mean, we can get to front lines of people, I mean, amendments of people are really worried about certain things. Okay, we have Josh. Okay, we have Ethan.
I just want to say, apparently, I definitely spoke too soon. I said summaries. And what I was hearing for was that desire for a descriptor, which is not a title. It was curiosity to me is who wrote this, who's the author. I knew they didn't even say that because they're out there now, people that have written this in many ways. What I hear, though, is that this is a stand, and I also hear that this is one of many. And if there's a way to incorporate that even into a working, I don't want to call it a title, but descriptor, if it's just something to clarify and increase the possibility of many more to come, and it honors this.
The senior writer of our troop whispered into my ear a minute ago, he said, how about for a title, Why We Occupy Part One?
Wow. Yeah.
Take that as a friendly.
But you need something for a web link to click to the page. Because I have to have some things that's a good title.
Okay. All right, we got Alicia.
Well, I mean, that's a point that we've thought a lot about, actually.
It's not that we don't feel it.
Exactly. The decision that was made so far, that we could go another direction. The decision that was made so far was that we wanted to speak in the voice, as broad a voice as possible, of the 99%. That includes a lot of veterans, and that includes a lot of people who feel such a solidarity with veterans, that they acknowledge that if it weren't for different life choices, different parents, different life experiences, it could be us. So the we was meant to express if one of us or if some among us are going and doing these things, we all are. So that's how it stands now. So I'm not accepting it as a friendly, but if that turns into a big concern, I mean, we certainly can.
Okay, we've got Bonnie.
I think this is just a small concern, but readability and reading level. So I think that I think when I try to do definitely for broad audience, I try to make people reading level pretty low, so that regardless of not too much education behind it. I think the reading level for the staff is a little bit higher than I would do for a normal broad document. It's something to think about. I like it, but I'm just saying that I probably wouldn't, just from my own position, like, I probably wouldn't do it as like a general thing.
It's interesting.
Okay, we've got John.
Okay, as far as the anger, we talked about anger before. This is the weak as a veteran. And when I read this, is talking about the military man is talking about we, the military personnel, who had to go through this. Y'all didn't have to go through this. The we, the anger disorder is what they classify the returning guys from there so they don't get medical. They have a repressive anger disorder. That is the classification that the government, that the military is putting on them. You know, so far as this we, no, the we, when I look at it, the we is we military people. It doesn't involve anybody. It's we, the military people, is what we went through, what we're going through now.
And I would say that's another legitimate interpretation of the we. It's another way you can read it.
Okay, let's remember everybody we're on concerns right now. We're already stable. It's sort of. Okay, we're doing all again. Okay, Dan?
I don't know why every time that we pose something, that you guys just turn. You don't ever let anything stand on its own. It's just, let's tear this apart, let's take this piece, let's do this, let's do this, let's do this. If you feel so strongly about stuff like that, write it yourself. Propose something, get up there, and do it. This man, these people worked hard on this. Like you just want to rip it apart. It's every proposal.
All right, we got three people left on stack. Stack's closed. We've got Quinn. Can you speak up? Thank you. I would say, you know, we all care a lot. Let's try to be Chris.
I mean, I think that when you're talking about war, we don't need to be worried about offending anyone who doesn't know what I'm talking about. But, I mean, strongly. About it, because war is certainly the antithesis of any of that. I also think that maybe another little friendly amendment to what it's called is why we occupy now in part one. Because occupation has been happening and been forced on, you know, people to do it. Now it's a choice. And I think if we can somehow distinguish that, that would be even better. I support the statement as it.
Angelica?
I think it was said. Someone was hesitant about adopting an anti-war stance at the risk of alienating people. I think it's very important to stand strong on the anti-war front. Not to say like what you've done is bad, you're wrong, and you're the enemy, but to say compassionately, like, I'm sorry you experienced that.
Sugarcoating what they do is a smack in the face to them. This is great from a warrior's point of view, from a service person's point of view. Why? Who are we to take that from them when they are literally our representatives in other countries? This is what they're forced to do.
I feel like it's really important for me to clarify what I said.
Okay.
I'm completely in support of an anti-war statement. I really like this statement. My concern with this particular paragraph is that, my work is with advocating for veterans so that they get the health care they deserve from the system. And somebody is out there giving veterans those missing rights. Someone is out there calling it a pre-existing condition. There are individuals making those calls. And I feel like those are, in my experience, individuals who are very pro-veteran. They're very pro-statements like this. And I feel like they're very much allied with this cause. But this particular thing sounds like it's attacking them because it's not clarifying
am part of a system just like the soldiers are, and just this huge thing that goes along. And I just feel like alienating the people that, you know, I work with regularly, who I know to be supportive of this movement, is just unnecessary.
Hold on there for how about just the simple insertion, instead we are too often labeled. Just the too often part means that sometimes those people making those calls, it's legitimate, but it happens far too often that it's just...
You're cool with that?
Yeah.
Error process is done all night. That's okay. Helen? Did Helen go?
Bella?
Oh, there you go.
To acknowledge everything would be difficult. But that's an important thing when you acknowledge that the point is. Yeah, maybe yes, and there may be a part two.
Okay. If there's no more like outstanding concerns, we're gonna move to friendly amendments.
Wait, just real quick. Are you a veteran and you really want to speak? Because what I'm doing really wanted to speak right now is Johnny, the Johnny just spoke. Calvin, Blue, Baby Beast the Wonder.
Some of the reasons that I occupy in this document, some of them are not. And like maybe we should just have a series of why we occupy cities with art that at some point reaches a level of inclusion and diversity that shows the migrant voices that we are. This is one voice that I don't think we have to label.
I don't fully understand why editing out the why we occupy part one, why editing out the part one better accomplishes that.
Because one, it takes away from the fact that there are infinite numbers. By putting the first qualifying number on it, you take away from the infinite number of reasons that we occupy.
So I guess we should
say... It's only the first number, it's not the last.
But it still makes us serious.
You can make it number 23,000.
Are you saying, can I just ask a clarifying question? Are you saying that what if we had like a series of poems that were all titled Why We Occupy? I think that's cool.
That's true. But how about this one is called Why We Occupy Part 1, but then we don't have a Part 2, 3, and 4. Next one is like Why We Occupy Economy. But it does take precedence because it's war.
But I think it
was something. Oh, but listen,
yeah.
Can you say that?
I'm not.
I'm not sure. I just feel like, you know, while my experience was safe and contained, and so it doesn't resonate in my mental container of memories or experiences, it doesn't rate at the top or at the bottom. I don't think that it should have a number. I think that we could just have a series of body numbers.
Okay, so the only we're gonna close stack after we hear from Blue, and I'm sorry, what's your name again?
Sean.
Oh.
I am a veteran. I served in Iraq. I went in 14 months after the fall of Saigon, so I had to go through POW training and a hell of a long basic training. Right? So I got lucky. I didn't have to fight in the real actual wars, but I've known a lot of men out here, especially a lot of these homeless veterans, because I'm homeless myself. Right? I think what he's done is a great statement. I like what Calvin says about why we occupy and look to a number. Because then somebody else can come up with why we occupy and write one about corporate greed or how we deal with health care and just have a series of them. I like that. That's a great idea. You know, that somebody else can come up with another one. I understand your concern about what you had to say. But the best way that I can put this whole thing in the way it was written up is for you to put yourself choose a soldier. Look at that and read that as a soldier. When he says we, he's talking about that soldier. Put your eyes into his shoes. Put your feet in his shoes. I walk around with a dead man's shoes that were in Afghanistan. Right? So I do walk in dead man's shoes. And that's the way you should look at this. You read it, look at yourself as a soldier who's been in battle, in combat. And I like what Helen says, that maybe there could be something added about the refugees who have been chased out of their own country for backing us. Right? I agree with that. Right? And I hope that it goes. Right, and I like I said, Calvin's idea is great, so I'm writing a bunch of them. Work with greed, healthcare, whatever you want to do.
Okay. Please go.
Yeah, I'm Sean. I serve in the Army, Iraqi Freedom. I really think we should pass this through. Sorry. I had a friend who committed suicide because the military wouldn't give him any support. He was crippled. Nothing ever happened. He's an unsung hero in my book. I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for him. Marines have died for me to be here. And they never got anything but a scar. And that's it. And I myself don't get any benefits from the military. I have pre-existing injuries. They took my whole entire record and made it blank because of what I've seen and what I know. And I really, really think this should go through as is, personally. Because I've seen my family, even though they were never soldiers, feel the same way. So they represent that we also. And I think that's what that we, to me, represents is everybody as a collective whole who never lost somebody. Ever in and out. And that's what it's about.
Okay, thank you. All right.
All right, so we're going to move towards friendly amendments. Friendly amendments for a statement. We feel, if you have any outstanding concerns that you need to be addressed through a friendly amendment, now would be the time to give them before we move. Census test as to whether this statement passes for a representation of our group. So, if anyone has any concerns with the linguistics of the statement that they want to see changed through a friendly amendment and have that friendly amendment ready in their heads, now is the time to present them.
I think we have a list of the ones that have been agreed upon so far.
So, all the ones from before, right?
Yeah, this is the definitive list as to the little changes. You add the children.
Do you want to read your list?
Sure. Yes.
Okay.
Okay, nothing is different on the first page. Second page, yet when we return from these hells we have experienced with. So insert we have hells we have experienced. A little further down, we are instead too often labeled as having repressive anger. Too often. A little further down, when we were made to invade a sovereign nation, go on raids. And I believe that also... when we are made to police a foreign land and protect political or corporate interests. We're also adding children to those lists. People, civilian, humans, children. A little further down, people, civilians, humans, children. Those are the ones that have been in and are now part of the document. And the title, why we it now stands at Why We Occupy. I'd like to briefly address two concerns that have not been incorporated. The one about simplicity of language. I think it's a good note. I think it would be way too difficult to go through and edit. I think that's something we should remember as we make further statements that make some sense. Although I don't like, you know, I'll be optimistic about what people might be able to understand. But it's a good note. the part about more seriously addressing refugees and others is, sounds to me like a legitimate concern. It also sounds to me like something that is going to, you know, it's going to shut it down and have it come up later. So I'm sort of hoping to, I'm sort of begging the indulgence of the people who feel strongly about that part to incorporate that in future offerings, or add your own opinion in comment sections, where comment sections will end up happening when this thing is on the internet. It's not perfect. It's not going to be perfect.
Glenn, what's the point of process?
Well, I mean, yes and no. This is a living document, so yes. Just like anything else we pass, we can add on. Part of the proposal was also that when we pass it, we send this out into the world, not just on the web, but we submit it to magazines, newspapers, everywhere. And when they publish it, obviously it's going to be published as is. But that could be a worthwhile process to dig back in. We could keep this alive for 10-20 years.
Well, I noticed that Helen had a friendly amendment, and since that was her concern, perhaps we should hear her proposal.
We also have Quinn.
Okay. So, thanks for that update on the existing amendments and concerns. Let's see if we've got a couple more.
Sure.
I think we're very close, and it's just getting better and better.
I don't like against the war.
My understanding is just why we occupy and we make a series of these on one every day.
For the sake, I have a good feeling, just looking at the room, that this is going to pass, and what we're trying. So the amendments now should be focused on things that you really need to that you think will facilitate making this better. Right? Do you want to keep thinking on that?
Oh no! I mean, you decide whether we're going to take more amendments, stuff like that. I'm just brainstorming what we might put after that colon. Because I wasn't in love with any of those, but there might be something.
Okay, well, let's
Let's hear more, Chris. And then Helen.
I guess we didn't say your amendment, but maybe just a suggestion that kind of answers. I know we didn't want to have a descriptor, but if it's called Why We Occupy, and then it was italics, you could put, this is one of a series of statements on Why We Occupy. This says that, you know,
Helen? Yes.
And I apologize for this. The cleaner staff is here, so I hate to,
How much time do we have? We're close.
But like, if we could, maybe like in the next 15 minutes, is that possible?
Yeah.
I want to hear. I want to hear amendments that you really, really need to happen, so that we can move to them. Wait, really?
Let's bring the joke.
Helen.
Right.
Okay, that's accepted. All right, please.
becoming justice, and if you could actually put some phrasing from documents already out there, it makes it hard.
I'm not like with Liberty and Justice Book. I want to respond.
Yeah. So we'll move to consensus voting then. To see how many people approve adopting this document for public aid. That seems like everyone. Any stand asides? Okay. Any people saying they don't like it? And any people that want to block it? Okay, passes.
Woo! Woo! Yeah. Wow.